Hello everyone, in today's video I'm sharing with you my Rite Aid in-store shopping hauls. I did happen to come out to my local Rite Aid store today to take advantage of some great sales and savings. If you have not yet had an opportunity to do so, please be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel as well as give this video a big thumbs up. Thank you so much for stopping by to see what I got in Rite Aid. So I did come out to Rite Aid earlier this week on Tuesday. You may already have watched my video, and I did go ahead and grab up a whole bunch of great deals and savings on Gatorade drinking products, as well as some Parodontax products. And I had some tracking established for the Parodontax / Sensodyne / Polydent, different items that are on a spend earn deal this week of spend $20, earn back $5 in bonus cash. So it was sort of like an extra incentive if I only came out again this week. We do have a wonderful spend booster going on. It's spend $30 or more before tax, before coupons, earn yourself back a whopping $10 in bonus cash. I do have two separate active barcodes that are working that I know of. It's the email barcode as well as the circular in-ad barcode. I did post those under my community tab in case you haven't received them. You can climb on over there and you will see from my post on Sunday. I did post out both codes that I do have. They are working. They are providing the bonus cash as intended. Some shoppers did indicate they had issues on Sunday shopping getting any bonus cash. If you are one of the victims of the IT issues, I do suggest reaching out to customer service as soon as possible so that they may rectify your bonus cash issues at hand. So as far as today's trip into Rite Aid, I did do a total of two transactions under two separate Rite Aid reward member accounts. I did want to focus on getting above $30 before taxing, before coupons, so that I can absolutely earn back on the spend booster of spend $30 before tax and coupons and earn back $10 in bonus cash. I did also want to finish my Sensodyne Parodontax, you know, tracking towards buy $20 or more this week, earn back $5 in bonus cash. Now, I'm not sure, however, many of you have looked at this week's sales. There is few and far in between, but there are some good ones. Some things going on is these select Rite Aid sold outdoor things, like it says like select you know, things from like pots and things like that. They're like 70% off their regular retail prices. So I saw that my store had some of these cement stepping stones. They are normally $14.99. I'm gonna share with you what they look like. So they are stamped and decorated and painted. Here is one of the UPC barcodes on the one that's the shine one. And normally $14.99, but since they're 70% off this week, they are coming down at just $4.49 for my store. Here is another type that they did sell at my store. This is the Hello one. And again, the UPC barcode, it might be the same, but they're normally $14.99. This week, 70% off. So you can grab them for just $4.49. So I ended up grabbing what they had in the store because they had select items on sale at 70% off. So I was really happy with that. I did also go ahead and grab under each of my transactions one Parodontax product and one Sensodyne product. Reason being that I grabbed two for my transaction is obviously it was going to go ahead and boost me closer towards that $30 that I was looking to spend. And in addition to that, they are on sale. Buy one product, get the second 50% off. You are able to mix and match. So meaning if you wanted to go ahead and grab, for example, a Sensodyne product, and then you wanted a second one, be it a Sensodyne again product or a Parodontax or that, you can mix and match. The second one either way will come up at the 50% off price. That's gonna be the lower priced item. So I wanted to make sure I grabbed one of each, because in addition to that, we did receive some coupons at the beginning of June for $1 off select Parodontax products, as well as $1 off select Sensodyne products. Now, my coupon for Sensodyne did state that it is good for use and redemption now through July 9th. However, my coupon for the Parodontax said that it was set to expire today, which happens to be July the 4th, Independence Day. And thank you to all of our special veterans who have served. Thank you so much for your service, and we do appreciate you being able to work so hard together to grant us this wonderful, beautiful freedom and enjoyment in life here in the United States of America. So thank you, and God bless the USA. Okay, so I did want to go ahead and make sure that I can use up that Parodontax coupon. So that's why I grabbed one of each for each transaction. We also have Shopmium rebate app offers on Parodontax as well as Sensodyne products too. Now with Shopmium, it doesn't allow you to like combine coupons with offers and things like that. So user discretion advised. I always like to upload my receipt anyways. If it credits me, great. If it doesn't, nah, that's all right. At least I tried. So I made sure on each of my transactions, I got a Parodontax and a Sensodyne to use those coupons. I did find one pack of these toothbrushes. These are the Sensodyne toothbrushes. They are priced normally at $6.49. I wish I would have been able to find more of these, because obviously it would have lowered my out-of-pocket costs quite a bit, that I could have thrown in more nice filler items, so to say. So I grabbed these, normally $6.49. I grabbed this Parodontax at my store. They are priced at just $7.99. And then I also was able to find one of these Sensodyne toothpaste that is priced at, let's see here, I think it's $7.49. Okay, $7.49 for this one at my store, which is lower than the Parodontax pricing. Okay, so essentially I paid for the Parodontax on each transaction, $7.99 each. And then the items that were of the lesser value, the Sensodyne ones, those were the ones where I got my 50% off. On one of my transactions, I grabbed all of these stepping stones. And on that same transaction, I grabbed these two. And also I did grab a pack of Oreo 89 cent cookies as well. I threw away the packaging. It wasn't for me, it was for my little one. I also, for the other transaction, grabbed these two, the Parodontax and the Sensodyne. I picked up three of these awesome premium marble cable, well, you break it, we fix it guarantee charging cords. This one's a USB-A to Lightning. This one is a USB-A to USB-C. And this one is a USB-A to USB-C. They were normally $9.99, but they rang down to just $2.49 each. So definitely fantastic filler item. I'd wanted to grab these with my excess bonus cash. So definitely an awesome buy for me. If your store has them, they would be located in the electronics section. That usually is somewhere on like one of the walls or that, but I don't know the layout of your store specifically. exactly. The other item that I grabbed for this second transaction was these Bic Soleil Escape razors. The reason why I chose to grab them, they are on sale this week at buy one, get one 50% off. And I know I did post up like a little sneak peek preview in my community tab about like the new Gatorade offer. When the new Gatorade offer came up, the new Bic offer came up. It says $3 cash back via Ibotta rebate app with a hot limit of 2, which is great because they're buy one, get the second one 50% off. So I was able to snag $3 back on each, but at my store, these ones were priced at $7.69. So you pay full price for the first one, you get 50% off for the second one. So that's my second transaction. Altogether, between everything, including these four stepping stones that are normally $14.99, the three cable chargers, the four Periodontax Sensodyne products, as well as the Bic razors, the regular retail price was over $137. I ended up getting it down with all of my coupons and savings in that to approximately $20.66 after rebates, rewards, points. I bought it everything. And how I did that is I'll share with you my receipt and the transactional breakdown. So this is my first transaction. There is the PowerTech cables, each ringing up for $2.49, regularly $9.99 each, 75% off. There is my Periodontax. This is the 3.4 ounce toothpaste. There is a dollar off coupon that I was talking about that was set to expire today. Also, there is the 50% off the Sensodyne toothbrush that was regularly $6.49. My coupon regarding the Sensodyne products that I had from that same flyer with the coupons with the Periodontax products, they had to manually enter it. So that's where you'll see that. That's why I was actually able to get credit on the Shopmium rebate app as like a little present to myself. And there you will see my two Bic Soleil razors. First one ringing up at full price of $7.69. Second one ringing up for $3.84. With tax, I paid $29.33. I did earn back $15 in bonus cash. I did use up all of my bonus cash that I had earned from Tuesday's earnings plus my point conversion. So out of pocket, I had to pay about $5.33. It is a little bit disappointing, but keep in mind with this rebate, I'm getting back $6 and that's cash. And then also with the Sensodyne toothbrush 2-pack, I'm getting back $1 via the Shopmium rebate app. So altogether, that's definitely more than what I paid out of pocket. So I'm very happy with that. I did earn back 302 points, which is equivalent to approximately 60 cents in Rite Aid money. And here is the breakdown of where the $15 came from. I utilized that circular in-app barcode of spend 30, get back $10 in bonus cash. And there you see that I bumped up by buying those two products to over $20. When you spend $20 or more before tax and before coupons, you earn back $5 in bonus cash. So there it says bonus cash rewards have been awarded from the purchase of GSK all oral, and that's like all GlaxoSmithKline oral care. So that's the first transaction. Basically, the breakdown comes out to be $29.33, got back $15 in bonus cash, 60 cents in points, $6 via the Ibotta rebate app submission, and I got back $1 for the Shopmium Sensodyne submission, $6.73 altogether net out of everything. So the second transaction wasn't as great as far as savings go, but that's okay. Let's talk about it. I got the cement stepping stone priced at $4.49 each, normally $14.99. And there's the fourth one. Okay. The Oreo singles, which was 89 cents. Not that bad. If you're looking for them, they come with like six Oreos. And if you think about how expensive cookies are, not that bad. Okay, filler item. There you see the Periodontax, $7.99. The coupon that was set to expire today coming off great. There you see my Sensodyne gum mint toothpaste that bringing up at the 50% off price because everything's buy one get one 50% off. And there you see they manually entered in that dollar off coupon. I did pay $29.54. I only had $24 in bonus cash, like the last transaction, to cover everything after my bonus cash earned from Tuesday as well as my points conversion. So I did earn back $15 in bonus cash, approximately 61 cents in points earned. And here's where I earned my $15, $10 for the circular. And then I also earned back $5 in bonus cash for being bumped above $20 on the products like Sensodyne, Parodontax, Biotene, etc. And here's the breakdown as far as that transaction goes. $29.54, $15 in bonus cash, that's 10 for the booster, 5 for the Sensodyne Parodontax products, as well as 61 cents for the points, $13.93 out of pocket. But realistically, if I were to have bought these stepping stones, which 70% off garden decor planters and supplies, selection may vary by store, but if I were to buy them like, where it's at like a Lowe's store or a Home Depot, I might end up having to pay $14.99. So to only pay $4.49 and then use like bonus cash and earn bonus cash, I think it's a win-win. So $13.93 for the four stepping stones, the little pack of Oreo cookies, as well as the Sensodyne and the Parodontax products, is really great to me. So altogether, everything came out to be $20.66 for $58.87 in stuff. That's the sale pricing. So it's $75.35 off regular prices approximately, because that's what my receipt said at the bottom when I looked at it. And it says approximately 65% off the sale prices, 85% off regular retail pricing at Rite Aid. So I am very, very happy with my progress and sales transactions as far as my visit on this lovely Independence Day. If you are planning on heading out to Rite Aid this week, try and have some better ideas besides what's the obvious. Like, for example, if you can't find like the toothbrushes and the Tums, for example, you know, these might be a nice little filler item, because if you think about it, you're spending, you know, just over 10, you're spending like 11 something, but it's 33% of the way there as far as the spend booster, or spend 30, get back $10 in bonus cash, and you're getting back $6 in Ibotta earnings, and it counts as two offers towards like bonuses. I know as far as my Ibotta rebate app, I did go ahead and end up getting an opportunity where if I go ahead and I do like 15 offers, I can go ahead and get $5 additional bonus money. So I don't know what you have as far as your bonus money is concerned, but there is plenty of different little things that you can consider besides just the obvious. If you want some kind of garden decor or little gnomes or little fairies or things like that, this may be the week that you want to pop on in to get the 70% off savings, as I've shared with you right there. I don't know exactly what's going on for next week, if they're going to have the same sale. Usually, like, Rite Aid would always have 70% off these items continually, but you never know what to expect or how inventory is going to go ahead and go. Like, if someone, like I bought all the stepping stones that were in the store, so there's no more stepping stones in the store, and my store isn't set to get like a truck or that until mid-July. So we have another like week and a half at least to even consider something new. So based upon inventory and stock and things like that, you know, you have to pick and choose. So you want to have some other ideas planned out for your visit, certainly. If you can use any kind of products around the house, whether it's food or whether it's, you know, something like, you know, cleaning products or things like that, you want to maybe put those on your list as a go-to item to help boost you to the amount that you want to be at in order to at least gain up on the spend booster appeal of everything. So I do hope you all enjoyed this wonderful, beautiful G-Money Saver Rite Aid in-store shopping haul. Be sure and like and subscribe for more great videos such as this one. And other than that, I will certainly look forward to catching you on my next video, be it today, tomorrow, or whenever I go ahead and upload again. Other than that, have a great, fantastic, safe holiday. And I will look forward to seeing you again soon in my next video. Thanks so much for watching. Take care now. Bye.